I'm here today at the Pulse.lk Theatre in Borella, a distinctive landmark in Borella, one which has been conceived by and built by and run with a lot of love and affection by the veteran thespian couple who we know from Ratigaya today's Namil and Malini Veeramuni. And I'm here today to talk to my guest Shanuki de Alwis on the show. I'm here today, as I told you, to meet my guest Shanuki de Alwis, whom I can't find. Shanuki! Shanuki, Miss, you are the Maha, the lady correct method.
I will give you a bloody shot across the
face.
What did you call me? Here, you mean that wasn't the bathroom?
That says, Padu, Dura Kathalaya. You mean you be in the toilet, in the phone box?
You don't need to know. Just don't go in there. Just stay out. Oh, God.
Stinks.
I told you.
What drama this show is. Oh, my God. Shanuki?
Yes. Where? Here.
Work with a lot of animals.
Work with a lot of animals?
I work with a lot of animals.
I live with a lot of animals.
Why animals and why not human beings?
Is that even a question? Come on, man. Like, look at what the human beings are doing to this planet. And look at what the animals are doing. See, I mean, that's not even a question for me. Anything that can speak, I don't get along with.
I can see that. Yeah. So, what do you do for animals, for cats, for dogs, for all this?
I think the question is, what do animals do for me, more than anything? Yeah. So, they are therapeutic, they're wonderful, I learn so much, everybody learns so much. They're healers, they're teachers in life, and unfortunately, what I find is that as time goes by, less and less people are caring, less and less people are aware of the magnificence of the environment and of the animal kingdom, and how integral they are to our existence.
What have your pets done to you as a human being?
Apart from giving me all my grey hairs and taking away whatever black that are left, like
that bond you have with them.
I don't think unless you have pets and unless you are an animal lover, it's very difficult to explain to somebody what it is. It's a magical connection. It's, you look into the eyes of an animal and you can understand each other. I feel like I can understand my pets and they can understand me completely. And there is a soul that is much older than ours in an animal.
Really?
Yes. And you know, there are people in this world who call themselves animal whisperers. So they have telepathic communication with animals and things like that, and they can actually heal through that communication. And animals can help heal us through that kind of connection. And I think in the ancient times, even in Sri Lanka, we had a symbiotic harmony with animals. We coexisted. We learned
how to... In what sense?
In every sense. I think in the ancient world, a lot of... humanity and the environment worked hand in hand. And if you take the Red Indians, if you take even the Vedas, the way they coexist with the environment today, all that knowledge, that wisdom, that ancient, that understanding of each other's souls has got lost in time through this rubbish that we call life.
What about zoos then?
Horrible places to be.
Okay, what about open zoos?
No, still, I mean, I don't believe in the concept of captivity. I think animals belong in their homes as much as we belong in ours. I don't think it's right for us to take them away from their natural habitat and put them in a box or even in a fence, just so that we can derive some entertainment. A child knows, I read this somewhere, this is not some magnificent thing I came up with, but a child knows more about dinosaurs than an elephant. And the child never saw the dinosaur in a cage, no? So I'm saying they...
Same principle.
Education is far more valuable and far more, I think, real if you expose your children to the natural habitat of an animal rather than taking that child to a zoo and saying, this is the way you get used to seeing an animal within bars or within...
Tourists on elephant rides?
No, absolutely not. This I can go on for hours, we don't have hours, but the...
We have 7-8 minutes the most.
The process of training, we call it crushing, it's a process called crushing an elephant in captivity to domesticate it enough and to tame it enough for tourist rides or joy rides is extremely traumatic. It is inhumane, it is unethical, and it is something that we do to these animals. And these animals are, I think, I don't know, I can't explain the horror that they go through simply for some fat lump to get on that
fat
and go
lump.
For a ride. It doesn't have to be white, even the brown lumps get on it.
Yes.
You know, there's absolutely no. Tourist rides should be stopped. Banned.
In Navala, in relative free captivity, I use that word.
From the little bit I know with those who work in the field of elephant protection and conservation, Pinnavela began with the right intentions. It is not operating under the right intentions now. It is more of a commercial venture. It is more for the money that we make out of it. So I don't think Pinnavela also can be cited as a responsible conservation effort. Sorry.
Okay, last question. How many animals do you have and who and what are they?
At the moment, I have three dogs named Oliver, Dodger and Annie. I have three cats named Isis, don't judge, Tinkerbell and Music. I have a rat named Templeton and I have a large rat snake named Sirius.
Sirius, and what are you in this whole thing?
I am, I think, a food facilitator as far as I'm mummy, basically.
Okay. And Wilbur?
And Wilbur. So
Wilbur is
Wilbur is my pot belly. One that I'm very proud of, one that I have nurtured over the years and developed into this fully grown man that he is. And Wilbur is actually a co-star with me in my productions on stage and stuff, and everybody knows Wilbur. He has a social media presence of his own. I'm not ashamed.
So bye Wilbur, I'll meet Shanuki in the next sequence somewhere here.
He's not making the noises he's used to making, but yeah, he says bye too. He loves you, Kumar.